This is section 2.1, and we're going to start out talking about the average rate of change, which should be familiar. So if we look at this picture right here, you've got a curve, but you've got a secant line that goes through that curve. And if we don't know what the x values are, we can just say this is x sub 1, f of x sub 1. This is x sub 2, f of x sub 2. And we note that we went 8 units. So the change in x here is also 8. So the average rate of change with respect to x over the interval from x1 to x2 is the change in the y's, which delta y is f of x2 minus f of x1. Over the change in x's, that's x2 minus x1. We can also write x1 plus h, because this x2 is this x1 plus h units in our picture, minus f of x1. So that should look pretty kind of familiar. Y minus y over x minus x, that's slope, which is an average rate of change. So in our example, find the average rate of change of the function over the given interval. So we have f of x is x cubed plus 1 over the interval from 2 to 3. So we've been given x values and we want to find the y values and then calculate the slope. So we need to do f of 3, which is f of this, minus f of 2, over 3 minus 2. You're always going to go right to left on your subtraction. So if I'm plugging in 3, I've got 3 cubed plus 1 minus 2 cubed plus 1. And I would suggest putting that in parentheses so you don't mess up on signs. And then 3 minus 2 is 1. So ultimately that equals 19. So that is going to be your average rate of change. Our next example has some trig in it. We will usually have a trig part in most everything that we do, so need to brush up on your trig identities and trig functions. So h of x equals cotan x on the interval from pi over 4 to 3 pi over 4. So we use that same formula. We're going to have h of 3 pi over 4 minus h of pi over 4 over 3 pi over 4 minus pi over 4. So if 3 fourths pi minus 1 fourth pi, that's going to be 1 half pi. So we'll call that pi over 2. And then we look up here, cotan of 3 pi over 4. If you're not remembering, you need to go back to a unit circle and find or figure that out. We need to start remembering our trig, and we should remember that that's when it has the 4 on the denominator, it's going to be related to the 45 degree angles, and tan of 45 is 1, so cotan of 45 is also 1, but you have to think about the quadrant that you are in. So cotan of pi over 4, you're in quadrant 1, that's a 1. Cotan of 3 pi over 4 is in the second quadrant, and tan or cotan are negative there, so you have a negative 1. Once you get that down, you've got negative 1 minus 1. So now we have negative 2 over pi over 2. We'll flip this one. So we have negative 2 times 2 over pi. That's negative 4 over pi, and that would be your answer for that one. So that was the average rate of change between two points on a secant line going through a curve. Now, if we're talking about the slope of a curve, the slope of the tangent line is the slope of the curve. We need to think about three things. One, start with what you can calculate, namely the slope of the secant, PQ. So here we've got this curve, and we've got a point P and a point Q, and we could figure out the slope of that. Investigate the limiting value of the secant slope as Q approaches P. So as Q gets closer and closer to P, we're thinking about that limit. If the limit exists, take it to the slope, take it to be the slope of the curve at P, and define the tangent to be to the curve at P to be the line through P with that slope. So let's talk about that a little bit in an example. If we're finding the slope of the curve at a given point, an equation of the tangent line for y equals x squared minus 3 at the point 2, 1. And so we're going to think of Q, that's our point P. Point Q is, and we're going to just move it h units because we don't have a real number there, 2 plus h would be the x value, and f of 2 plus h would be the y value. All right, so we're going to find the slope of that secant line between P and Q. So we've got f of 2 plus h squared minus 3, and then we're going to go ahead and use the y value that we're given for P, so minus 1. That is f of 2. F of 2 is 1. All right, so now let's go down and look a little bit further. In this step, I just squared the 2 plus h. And so I have 4 plus 4h plus h squared, and then I have minus 3 minus 1. In this step, I combine the minus 3 and minus 1 and have a minus 4. So now I have 4 plus 4h plus 8 squared minus 4. I can cancel out the 4s. And so now I have 4h plus h squared over h. And I am taking the limit as that distance between P and Q goes to 0, right? So I cannot direct substitute this h in this 0 for h because that would be undefined. So I'm going to factor out h up here. If I take h out, I'm left with 4 plus h, and I still have h on the bottom. This is algebraically working around the issue. So then the h's can cancel out, and I have the limit as h approaches 0 of 4 plus h. Now I can plug that 0 in there, and I get 4. So my slope, using this point, my slope is now 4. And we need to remember this equation, point slope. So we have y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. That's your point slope format. And we'll just plug in what we've got. We've got y minus 1, there's your y1, equals m, there's your 4, times x minus 2, that 2 there. So we've plugged in our 2, our 1, and our 4. And we'll clean it up. We'll distribute here and get 4x minus 8. We'll add the 1 over and we get y is 4x minus 7. That is the equation of the tangent line. So in our section, in the problems, we'll be doing both. We'll do some average rate of change, and then we will do some where we're taking the slope of a curve and finding the equation of the tangent line. So let's go look at our problem set. All right, let's look at number one. Find the average rate of change of the function over the given intervals. So you've got f of x is 6x cubed plus 6. Over the intervals, you have a is 1 to 3 and b is negative 6 to 6. Let's go over a because I think if you can do one, you should be able to do the other. This is straight algebra. So we have f of 3 minus f of 1 over 3 minus 1. So that means you're plugging in 3 into your function and 1 into your function. So 6 times 3 cubed plus 6 minus 6 times 1 cubed plus 6, all over 3 minus 1, which is 2. You do that math and you end up with 156 over 2, which is 78. So the average rate of change there is 78. I think you should be able to do the negative 6, 6. Just watch your signs very carefully. Put things in parentheses when you're subtracting, and that should be helpful. Number two says, find an equation for the tangent line to y equals negative 5 minus 7x squared at negative 3 minus 68. So this is your P. This is the point P. And I would say to get used to this, over here just write Q is going to be whatever your x value is, negative 3 plus h, f of negative 3 plus h. So here's my Q. Delta y over delta x is going to be negative 5 minus 7 times, and this is my x, so in the Q part, negative 3 plus h squared minus, and then my y value is a negative 68. So I have negative, and I have on the bottom, negative 3 plus h minus a negative 3. Now, once you have that in, you are cleaning this up. So we're going to square negative 3 plus h. Be careful with your signs. You get that. So you have negative 5 minus 7 times that. That's a minus minus. So we have plus 68 all over h. And we're taking the limit as h goes to 0. And I don't have that all written there, but that's what's happening. And so when you multiply the negative 7 here, this is what you get. And then we see that negative 63 and negative 5 cancels out with the positive 68. We cannot plug in h. I should have this written up here. We can't plug in h is 0. So we want to typically look here, factor out the h right here. Left leaves me 42 minus 7h. You can cancel out those h's. Now at that point, we can plug in 0 for h, and we are left with 42, which is our slope. Using our point slope form and the point P that we were given, we can write the equation of the tangent line. Now that all is just algebra, so that should be familiar. We'll do the same thing with number 3. And you are given y equals x squared minus 3x minus 2, and your point is 2, negative 4. And we want to use finding the limit of the secant slopes through point P. So think of Q as 2 plus h and f of 2 plus h. So change in y would be 2 plus h squared minus 3 times 2 plus h minus 2 and then minus a negative 4. So this is all just doing it with the f of 2 plus h. And then on the bottom, we have 2 plus h minus 2, minus that 2. So on the bottom, we're left with h. We clean this all up, and if things are going right, we're going to have things cancel out. So we have a minus 6 and a minus 2. That's minus 8. There's a positive 8. We are left with 4h plus h squared minus 3h over h. And this becomes h plus h squared over h. We'll factor out h, and we are left with 1 plus h. When we take h going to 0, the limit of that, we get 1. And m is the limit as h approaches 0 of 1 plus h equals 1. So that's our slope. Then you write the equation of your tangent line using your point that you were given. And you have y equals x minus 6. All right. We come down here. Number 4. The graph below shows the profits of a small home business for the decade of the 90s. And so find the average rate of change of profits for the interval specified and the rate at which they were changing in the specified year. So our question says, what's the average rate of change for the interval year 2 through 4? 2 through 4. So here we've got 2, and I highlighted that with yellow. So 2, the point is 2, 2, and 4, we've got 4, 8. So we've got 8 minus 2 over 4 minus 2, which is 3. And this is in thousands. So that rate of change is 3,000 for this here. Now, it wants to know what at the rate at which profits were changing in year 7. So we The average rate of change for the year 6 to 7, so that's 6 to 7 right here, is 24.5 minus 18 over 7 minus 6, and you end up getting 6.5. The average rate between 7 and 8, we did the same thing. So the rate at which the profits change in year 7 is approximately half of this sum, if you're taking the average of that, and you would get 7, which is 7,000. So that is a way to come up with that question. Let's look, where is 5? I'm not sure what has happened to my 5, but let's look at 6 and 7. Those are average rate of changes, and that's what we did in the first question. And you can do that in number 6 and number 7, and I think they're very similar, so you should be able to do that. Let's look at number 8. That does have a trig in it. G of t is 2 plus tan t over the interval negative pi over 4 to pi over 4. And so you're doing the same thing. This is average rate of change. And we'll do 2 plus tan of pi over 4 minus 2 plus tan of negative pi over 4 over pi over 4 minus a negative pi over 4. That means we're adding these, so we end up with pi over 2. This is very much like the example question that we had. And we end up with 2 plus 1 minus 2 plus a negative 1. So that's 3 minus 1. We get 2 over pi over 2, which is 4 over pi. So that is number 8. Number 9, which I believe is the last question. Find the slope of the curve at the given point. So just like we have done on the other ones, we have y equals x squared plus 5x. Point P is 4 comma 36. Q is going to be 4 plus h, f of 4 plus h. And it's multiple choice, but let's just go through and see if we can come up with what we're supposed to do. So the slope is going to be the limit as h goes to 0 of 4 plus h squared plus 5 times 4 plus h minus the y value there, which is 36. On the bottom, we have 4 plus h minus 4. When we do all of that out algebraically, the 16 and the 20 will cancel with the minus 36. We have 8h plus 5h, which is 13h plus h squared over h. We'll factor out the h. We got 13 plus h, and the limit as h goes to 0 of that is 13. So my slope is going to be 13. And then we plug in the 36 and the 4 from here, x and y, plug them in, and your final answer would be y equals 13x minus 6. So we did some average rate of change, and we did some slope of the tangent line to get us started on this. So I think that will get you good for section 2.1.